This portion of the vlog is dedicated to Jay Valentine. We're at Bangers.
We were right next to Kyoten, and I thought we were going to go there, but they were all like, let's go to Bangers. So here we are. It's a little beer garden. And this street is just full of like little bars built into old houses, actually, which is kind of cool. I'll show you this one over here. It's kind of neat.
I mean, Dave and I were pretty lucky.
Place is called the Seals. Just a nice cool place to hang out and drink, I guess. Haven't tried this one yet. And then there's a whole bunch of food trucks over there. A little food truck area for it. There's Flippin' Azzy over there. We're in that corner today. Place is pretty big. You guys order your beers yet?
We did. Well, I asked to try one. There was no drama this time. You know, we ordered the food and he got poutine. Did you want peanuts or no?
No. They have a lot of seasonal beers every month, and limited, and they sell out, so they put these like little sold out.
This is printed
stamps.
Every day.
Yes.
Every day.
So, a lot of beer drinkers here. What are you going to try?
I'm trying the beer on cask.
Which one is that?
I don't know. Oh. It's just you usually have one.
Cask engine. What are you trying?
I might do the same. Oh. It looks interesting. Just from the description.
So,
would you like to read it?
This cask is the traditional English pub-style way to serve beer, known in the old world as real ale. This is a less cold, less carbonated presentation, naturally carbonated by the yeast present in the cask, or firkin, and from there, pulled up to your glass by a hand pump. Expect a more raw product that's full of subtlety with the added flavors of extra hops or another interesting ingredient in the cask.
That's good.
Ooh, I'm gonna get one. When the beer snob says it's good, it's gotta be good.
Oh, that is disgusting.
How's that bad?
How is that good?
Do you like it?
Yeah.
It tastes like stagnant water that's been sitting out with rocks.
Stagnant water.
Like river rocks.
River rocks and moss.
And moss. Diet Coke, baby. Oh, I was going to show the seasonal beers.
Oh.
Yeah.
Ones. They usually have 100 and something on tap.
The Green Flash.
They have a strawberry milk stout.
Ooh, strawberry milk stout. Look, how are you not going to get that?
I had that before.
Oh, strawberry milk stout?
Yeah.
Oh. Here's the other side.
The other side. It's
good that you're showing that because it's going to be the same spot.
Well, it's just showing the options.
These are the ones that they have.
Non-rotating?
The non-rotating beers.
Non-rotating!
Any.
Rotating.
Which one's the one you normally get? The chocolate?
I have a beer flip.
The chocolate. Thank you. Poutine.
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 I got a small, is that okay?
Yeah, that's plenty.
Did you ever watch that show, Parks and Recreation?
Poutine.
This is like beer and wine combined. I know that sounds gross, but it's actually pretty good.
I like it. I actually like that beer.
It's really good.
Look, you can even see the cheese curds in this.
Curds in whey.
I just got gravy on my hand.
Did you grab one of this? Mm-hmm. Mm.
Flip's gonna get a free tattoo. You get a free tattoo to express your love of bangers. Right there.
It's like free advertising.
You wanna have it?
No.
It's free.
I'm not getting it.
Cheese curds.
And whey.
Nice. Flip got, what kind of sausage did you get this time?
The usual, venison, has venison and other stuff in it.
And he chooses to get a salad with it. And we just demolished the poutine.
Poutine.
Poutine, and you get a
habanero dog?
Habanero dog.
Which is hot as fuck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh man, look at all that seasoning.
Look how red it is.
How's your beer?
Very good.
How's the beer?
Very good.
I got the bangers and mash. Just mashed potatoes and a sausage. I don't really know if it has a special name, the sausage. Just wiener. So, my wiener fell off the mash. But
she's fixing it with a knife.
It's like,
sorry, Theon.
Sorry, Theon. Sorry, Theon.
Nice.
Oh, man. What a great scene.
Which one?
It's pretty old.
Show enough, right?
What?
Show enough.
Show enough?
Yeah.
He died many years ago. He was only 56. Mm. Died in 2008.
He was cool. Yeah. Night court.
He was in,
we're gonna make a lot of watch The Last Dragon.
He was in The Adventures of Briscoe County Jr. He was awesome. Lord Bowler?
Yeah.
Briscoe County Jr.
Why are you looking up Last Dragon actors?
Because I like looking up to see where they are. You know, besides being dead, which is unfortunate.
I, in the meantime, are going to do something more productive. I'm going to eat this Snicker jar. This is basically ice cream with caramel and chocolate and a little bit of nuts, and it's called a Snicker jar. And it is awesome.
It was frozen just like 5 minutes ago.
Yeah. So good. Like a melty, snickery jar of awesome.
As a side note, the auction house on Hex went live.
The what?
The auction house on Hex went live. In case anyone was wondering.
Tableside guacamole. I cut up the fresh guacamole for you. Make it into awesomeness. Chunky. Chunky style. We got misters going here. Keep getting sprayed in the face. In the face. Say you like bukkake. He doesn't know what that is. Which is good. It's a good thing. It's not a bad thing. For the best.
I think I've had, it doesn't take much, pretty much a lightweight, but I had some Mexican.
You're so wasted.
I'm not wasted, but the waitress just brought our food, and I was like, she asked us if we're all set, and I said, I think we're grid.
Grid.
Because I couldn't decide where I was going to say great or good. So I said grid. Anyway, here's my food. I got the stacked pork enchilada. And it's got an egg on it. And let me show you the inside of this beauty.
Look at that. Are stacked
up. Oh. Look at that.
Oh, yes. You get the same thing, Flip?
And he got a shrimp taco with...
No, fish.
Fish taco with...
White fish marinated in tequila.
This stuff on it.
Mango.
I'm ruining the plate. I'm ruining the presentation.
Boring. Okay, back to this.
And they said, if I have another Mexican martini, we can't watch...
The Last Dragon.
I'll be able to watch The Last Dragon, finally. Well, let me try it. Good. Very good.
Yeah.
So excited we're home. And staying this time instead of going out again. Huh. Are you going to go ride bike riding? Is Flip going to take you bike riding?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Flip didn't get his bike today. It was on hold. Daisy, down. Down. Good girl.
Let's see if this even exists on YouTube.
I don't think so.
Yeah.
I don't think there's anyone out there that would take the time to read. Like, all they probably could do is just re-record it.
If it's not even good enough to rip to MKV, it is not worth watching.
It doesn't matter.
But that's
it's
not
still
going
to be the same res, the same quality. You're just changing the file format that it's recorded on. It's all you're doing. You're not making it better.
Then, like, what's the point?
Yeah, it's not remastered.
There is no remastered.
You're not gonna, just come on. Just,
there is
just,
no remastering. It's just DVD. It's all you get.
I'm going to remaster your mom.
In the face.
Yes, see what I have to put up with, world? See what I have to put
in
up with?
In the face.
There is nothing better than DVD.
Daisy. In the face.
Bukkake.
Do you like bukkake?
No.
How do you know? Have you tried it?
Nope, I'm not going to try it. That's for Flip.
No. Let me go double check.
Gonna be the same.
Yeah.
They're trying to get me to watch The Last Dragon.
Leeroy!
I'm being forced to watch The Last Dragon. We're about, I hope to God we're like 3/4 of the way through, but whatever.
No.
Really?
No, yeah, it's not
bad. It is so bad. Like, so, so bad.
Is it?
So,
it's not that bad. Is it?
I don't know who you are, pal, but you're in a lot of trouble. And I went to go to the bathroom, and they're like, you want me to pause it? I'm like, no. And then they paused it.
I love when he breaks through the door, and he's like, who's this guy? We didn't order out.
This is so racist.
The whole movie's racist.
The movie is so racist.
That's part of the point. It's funny, like that scene where...
But that's not why it's bad.
There were 50 guys, and they were black. And then they show a black guy adding to the conversation.
He's like, and
they
had
chains.
The best part is his brother, Richard, who's explaining to Leeroy the mechanics of like how he's not ready for sex.
The art of having sex. He's like, you even got a paintbrush.
You don't even have a paper.
Oh my god. Anyways. got like maybe, I hope to God, less than 30 minutes left, but we'll see.
I finished it,
and just an FYI, this movie does not hold up. You cannot watch this movie. It is not one of those classics that just can span three generations and be okay.
It is so dated.
The
only exception is if you've already seen it like 100 times.
It's so bad. Richie was like, his brother was the coolest part. Well, that and the little Asian dude.
Yes.
Is he Reyes Jr.? Is he the guy who is in Red Sonja who's like, boy? I see no boy.
Yeah.
Yes, I love that little kid. He's so cute.
He was in the Rundown and he was one of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, and he was also as in...
He's got to be like 40 now.
I don't know. He was...
Right? Something like that. Probably. Close to it.
He's a very skilled martial artist, though.
No, he's probably younger than me.
Oh, really?
Well, I don't know, because I was watching this when I was younger, and he was younger than me when I was watching this.
Yeah, that's
when
true.
It came out.
That's true.
He's probably in his mid-30s. Hmm. Imagine.
You should watch the Rundown clip that he's in. Look like butterflies, sting like a bee.
That was a good movie. Better than I expected.
I'd rather watch The Rundown than this. This is so bad. So bad. But I definitely think I could have enjoyed it if I watched it when I was a kid. If I had watched it when I was a kid, I would have enjoyed it.
Yeah, it's fun.
Because it would have been funny and fun. And then the dancing, I would have been really like into it.
Isaac is awesome. I did not realize back in the day how annoying that Shogun part was. It was just like, really,
show enough. And how,
I can't hear you!
And how on PC the movie is.
Hmm?
And how on PC the movie is.
Who in Harlem would bust into a movie theater and like announce himself?
Just all the inherent racism.
Yeah. It was definitely like one of those things where I bet half those things that they said when you were a kid you didn't get.
So, like, you either didn't get it or you didn't get
you didn't need to get it.
You didn't get the impact of it. Like, a lot of the stuff I got...
Well, it's super crude.
It is, but a lot of the stuff I got, I just didn't realize, you know, how unpolitically correct it was.
Yeah, we didn't...
No, all those sexual innuendos, I would not have understood them when I was a kid.
Oh.
No way.
Well, I understood a lot of them, but I didn't think much of it when I was a kid.
Yeah.
Which is... And now you go back and, like, it's just, like, almost painful to hear some of the racist remarks they're making.
Well, it's like when you go back and people use, like...
Well, I mean, back then, they were a little bit more...
And some of it's absurd, too. Like, the guy's like, would you rather have something in a medium-sized Oriental? She's like, I'm not Jewish. And it's just like, what?
Well, even he was like, what?
I know.
Huh? I am so glad I watched this movie, though. Like, so happy I watched it. Because now, finally, I never, ever have to hear, you so need to watch this movie ever again.
I knew you were going to say that.
Yeah. Done. Did it. Check.